In the past week, a couple of patients came to see me because of hay fever, and currently it is pretty serious in Vancouver. So that inspired me to make this video, which is about the causes and treatment of hay fever from a Chinese medicine perspective. I remember when I was a kid, I have serious hay fever, and that is pretty painful. Especially during winter times and springtime, my nose is always stuffed and runny, and my eyes are so itchy that I have to constantly rub it till it's all red. But I'm happy to say that it is now cured and I have hay fever no more. And I will tell you how I exactly did it in this video. But first, let's talk about the causes of hay fever. When I talk about hay fever, most people will think it is about pollens, no matter it's grass, trees, or weed, or even stuff like mold or dust. From a Chinese medicine perspective, pollens are not the most important, but it is our body type. Because if you put the same group of people in the same environment with the same pollen, some people will have allergic reactions, some don't. And that is mainly because of the body type. So what can cause our body types to alter and being allergic to all these stuff? And the reason is often because we don't take care of ourselves. Usually hay fever is most serious in spring and summertime, but it often happens during fall and winter. And especially in winter times when it is so cold that the cold and wind can attack and invade our body. And when I mean cold and wind in Chinese medicine terms, it is an external pathogen that can attack and invade, and it can change our body condition. And we often like to drink cold and ice drinks, like cold water, drinks like pops and beer. And that can accumulate cold in our body and it can cause phlegm. And because we have phlegm, during summertime and springtime, when the yang energy starts to rise and elevate, it tries to expel the cold outside of our body, and that could cause hay fever symptoms. Of course, the best thing is to see a Chinese medicine doctor so that they can do acupuncture and herbal medicine to specifically tailor your individual body type. But if that is not possible, diet and self-massage is important to alleviate and relieve the symptoms. Now I'm gonna show you a set of self-massage techniques that can help to relieve the symptoms. And this set is simple. It has 5 basic pressure points, and each pressure point you can do about 2 to 5 minutes. And you can do this set up to 2 to 3 times a day, depending on how serious your condition is. Let me first explain. Pressure points are on the surface of your body, but it connects to the inside of your organs through meridians. And when you press the pressure points, it's usually pretty sore and sometimes painful. So when you press it, make sure it's not too painful that it's too unbearable. Just a little bit of soreness and sensitive, it's good enough. So the first pressure point is called the wind pond. And the reason why it's called the wind pond is because it is behind your head. And when wind attacks, it likes to attack that pressure point. So especially in wintertime, put on a hat and cover that so that it cannot invade your body. The exact location of wind point is behind your head. Right beside the spine is the trapezius muscle, or we often call it traps. It is when you pull it up, you can feel that there is a pit, there is a sunken spot, and that is the wind pond. What you can do is put your hands behind your head and use your thumb and press to that pressure point about 45 degrees upwards and frontwards. And you can feel really sensitive. You can press for about 5 seconds, release, 5 seconds, and release. The second pressure point that I'm gonna show you is called the welcoming fragrance, which is right beside your nose. And you can press using your middle finger, and then you can turn anti-clockwise and clockwise. The third pressure point is called the union phalli, which is located on your hand. This bone right here is called the index metacarpal, and in the middle of the bone, in the inner lining towards the thumb, when you press it, you can feel really sensitive. And it is usually really good for stuffed nose. If you have a left stuffed nose, you can press on your right hand. And when you have a right stuffed nose, you can press on your left hand. The fourth pressure point is called the bright eyes, which is located on the inner and upper side of the eye socket. When you press this pressure point, make sure you press slowly and gently. You can use your thumbs, press it slowly in, hold for a couple seconds, and release. The last pressure point is called the drilling bamboo, which is located on the inner end of the eyebrow. And when you press, you can use your index finger or your middle finger, press in, use anti-clockwise for a minute or two, and then clockwise for a minute or two. And for hay fever, patients usually have a stiff neck. So what we can do is we can use our palm, rub our neck for about 50 times till it's warm and hot. And what we can do is we can use our index fingers and middle fingers to pluck the muscle. So whenever you feel there is a tight spot right in the trapezius muscle, you can pluck outwards to make it more relaxed, and that could help to alleviate symptoms as well. And of course, diet is really important, especially when you have hay fever. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a link in the description below regarding an article that I wrote about the best food that you should be eating. Back to my story, how did I cure my hay fever? It is simply by doing martial arts and qigong exercises. And by doing that, it can improve my upright qi. And in Chinese medicine, one really important core principle is if you have upright qi in your body, it can expel any external pathogens so that you can be healthy. Thanks for watching today. If you have any questions, leave in the comment section below. And stay healthy, and I will see you in the next video.